I am Dr. Ashok Kumar, Department of Zoology and Industrial Fish and Fisheries, Ganga Singh College, Chhapra. Today I am going to deliver the lecture on riverine seed procurement, how seeds are procured from rivers. Riverine seed production is very important for the freshwater fish culture is increasing day by day to meet the food supply of the humans, and due to this emphasis, the demand of seed has been rising constantly. It was previously in West Bengal, this seed selection was well in advance in West Bengal, but due to the increasing or fast culture practices of freshwater fishes, now the seeds are now the demand. It was adopted by the neighboring states like Bihar, UP, and other states, and different types of from river, because it is natural. Now the germ plasm will remain intact, and hence natural seed would be better. So first of all, I will explain that we have the Central Inland Capture Fishery Research Institute, CIFRI, in head office Barakpur, Kolkata, East Pargana, 24 East Pargana, and now this CIFRI has established so many its center in on the bank of the different rivers of India, and there are certain factors responsible for fluctuation of quality food seeds, seeds of fish. And hence, first of all, I would like to give information that our natural resources, the rivers are the length of the river. The area of the rivers and along with this canal 1.71 hectares. So the river system of India, as I had already mentioned in Inland Capture Fishery Resources of India, we have divided it into the Northern India River and Peninsular India River. In Northern India River, the Northern India River, it is Ganga River system as well as Brahmaputra River system, and mainly Ganga River system and Brahmaputra River system and Peninsular India, it is East Coast and West Coast. In Northern India, it is Ganga River system, Brahmaputra River system, Indus River system, while in Peninsular India, it is East Coast River system and West Coast River system. In East Coast, Northern Indian river system, Ganga, Brahmaputra, and Indus river system, while in Peninsular India or Southern India river, it is East Coast and West Coast. East Coast river system is comprised by Godavari, Krishna, and Kaveri, while Narmada and Tapti river system, it is in West Coast river system. Now, things we have to for spawn or seed selection, riverine seed selection, we see the availability of the spawn the availability of the spawn collection, it depends on the different factors. First thing is choice, so we have to look over the following things. First is choice of site, means site selection. Second is net efficiency, or choice net efficiency means net selection. Site selection, net selection, and pre-monsoon observation or investigation. Site pre-monsoon, and to monsoon flowing pattern, it means monsoon investigation. First is site selection. Site should be selected during pre-monsoon months, and the river level is low. Survey should be made to be the area stretch of the river for assessing the abundance of major calves. During monsoon season, better collection size generally lies on the size of sloping bank. The track, or the water current just diverges. It goes just in this way, again this way, again this way, again this way. Now the current is going, suppose it is going to this way, and again meandering takes place. So here it is the erosion zone. The water current will strike this bank, and the soil will be erosion, and hence this, and then again it will after then it will reflect after colliding with the this side, it will turn in this side, again it will go this side. So this side where it strikes, that is erosion zone. And this side after erosion, it will go in this direction. So it is shallow region. It is shallow zone and it is erosion zone. It is erosion zone and it is, and just opposite to that is shallow zone. Now it will go in this side, it will become erosion zone, strike here, and erosion will take place, it will erosion zone, and again it will turn in this direction. So meandering of, so erosion zone, that where should we place the shooting net for capture of the spawn, that should be on the side of erosion zone, because fishes travel along in the current and travel in the current, and due to that centrifugal force, the spawn are casted off, and they are deposited towards the erosion zone, and shallow zone remains, that is sloping bank. So shallow zone is sloping bank, hence collection ground is made towards the erosion zone. So the net which is called shooting net is a type of net. First of all, it is a rod which is cylindrical. One rod is in this, and from there it becomes conical, and net comes gradually narrow and narrow. It starts from this, and then it is narrow and narrow and narrow towards backside, and in the backside there is a small net that is called gamcha. And when it is placed on the erosion zone, the left the spawns casted off from they come and they enter the shooting net, and ultimately it is captured in gamcha, which is replaced from time to time, and the spawns are collected kept in other bucket. Now gears used for collection of ribbon seed or ribbon spawn. The spawn collection, spawn as I had already mentioned, that spawn collection net is called, known as shooting zone. It is a which is a funnels type. Funnel type means here it is more and gradually it becomes narrower. So it is funnel separate net of finely woven netting, and is operated in shallow margins of a flooded river. The mouth of the net should face the current. And the mesh size varies from 8 to 20 per inch. In 1 inch, there are 8 divisions to 20 divisions, means small. If there is more turbidity, that should be small. If turbidity is less, then it should be less. So 8 to 20 per inch. The posterior end has a small ground opening fixed on a bamboo, where a small trough like receptacle. That receptacle is called gamcha. Gamcha, G-A-M-C-H-A, oh, gamcha. And this is the live spawn moving along with the live spawn moving along with the live current. That current is moving along with the current's collection. They are collected in the gamcha from where they are periodically removed and kept in bucket. 30 centimeter, it should be less than 30 centimeter per second, low current and low turbidity, less than 800 ppm turbidity, then 1 by 16 inch by 1 by 12. Now, the topic is different types of nets used in India for spawn collection, ribbon seed or ribbon spawn collection. For the first time, Rahman, in the year 1946, he developed Benchi Jal for spawn collection and used in eastern Bengal. And after that, it has been developed. It has been various varieties and designs have been developed, which are as mentioned. First is Murshidabad net, and this Murshidabad net is its mesh size is 16 to 20 mesh oblique inch. In 1 inch, the mesh should be 16 to 20 mesh. In 1 square inch, it should be 16 to 20 mesh in 1 inch. 1 inch, 16 to 20 mesh should be there, and it is mostly used in Bihar, in our state Bihar, as well as West Bengal. It is Murshidabad net. which has in 1 square inch 16 to 20 meshes are there, and it is used in Bihar as well as West Bengal. Second is Midnapur net. Midnapur net, its mesh size is 8 to 16 mesh in 1 square inch, 8 to 16 mesh oblique in 1 linear inch, in 1 inch, and it is used in West Bengal, as its name is Midnapur net. Midnapur is located in West Bengal. Third is Jaunpur net. It is a round size mosquito net, 2 mm size, which is also used in Bihar. And third and fourth is, Midnapur net, Jaunpur net. Now Gujarat square type mosquito net. In 1 mosquito net, square type mosquito net in Gujarat. net efficiency. Now, the shape, size and mesh size of net, generally the shape, size and mesh size of the net, that affects the efficiency for catching the spawns or flies from the river. So in low current, bigger mesh nets are better. When the current is low, the bigger mesh size in 1 inch, it should be 8 or it should be 10. In a low current, bigger mesh nets are better, while in higher current, a smaller mesh net are more comfortable, more suitable for collection of a spawn. Now, next point is pre-monsoon investigation. This investigation should be known about the stock in the rivers, species, carp stock, how much carp stock are there, matured carp stock should are there. So it must be known rivers, species and composition and sex ratio, how many males are there, how many females are there. So it should be before rainy season, it should be estimated how many calves, male and females, are present in that. Then behavior of a spawn in response to hydrobiological characters. Behavior of a spawn. First is flood level. Flood level is most significant character. Flood level is up to what height flood comes. So flood level is first important character, showing a positive correlation with the spawns. If it is very high, flood level is very high, the spawn will go outside. If it is very high, from the water will go up above the shore, above the corners, above the two sides of the river, it will go and it will spread in the adjoining fields. So it is flood level should be observed. Second is current direction. In which current? The operation mostly depends on the generation of the current in the river and its direction. If it is flowing in this way or in this way or in this way, in forward direction or in backward direction, now it depends there. So current direction in the river and its turbidity, if reduces the mesh size, if there is more turbidity, suspended matter in the water, that is turbidity. If there is turbidity, it reduces the mesh size of the net. Mesh size, if it is very much turbid, then mesh size should be small. It should be up to 20 in 1 inch. But if it is less turbid, then it should be 10, 12, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14, less turbid, it reduces. So if there is turbidity, reduces the mesh size. And then pH and DO2, there is no definite relation has yet been established between the pH of the water as well as dissolved oxygen of the water. Fifth is temperature. There is no definite relation has been established with the temperature as well as the spawn collection effect of spawn effect of temperature on the number of spawns. And this is all about the riverine fish seed collection, which is an important question for the forthcoming examination. You have to mention how it is operated, especially shooting net, how it is operated. Thank you.